Hola a todos and welcome to a new Spanish lesson with me, Sebas. This is the first video from the series Pronunciation and Orthography. Remember that if you have any particular topic you want me to do, you can put your comment below. As I said in one of my first lessons about the alphabet, I will make different videos about the pronunciation of the difficult letters like the letter R. The letter R, as I said in that video, has two ways to pronounce, a soft way and a hard way. The soft one has a similar way to pronounce it like an English R, but I would have to say that it's a little more close off. To make the S sound, you must push your tongue against your palate in a soft way. E-re. 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 On the other hand, for the hard sound, I would have to say that this is a little more difficult to pronounce as this is a really particular phoneme from the Spanish language. This sound is like pushing your tongue against your palate in a rapid and repeated way. E-re. 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 Well, I have to say that the best way to learn these phonemes is by practicing and listening a lot. Now, let's see in which cases we use both of them. The soft sound of the R in Spanish is pronounced in the following cases. When it goes after any consonant except of the letters N, L, and S. Ejemplo, protección, Cristo, grúa. When the letter R goes before a consonant. Ejemplo, marco, perla, ardor, corso. When the letter R is at the end of the word. Ejemplo, amor, jugar, tomar. You will notice that this rule applies to any verb in infinitive mode. When the letter R is between two vowels in the middle of the word. Ejemplo, puré, mirada. On the other hand, the hard sound of the R is used in the following cases. When the letter R starts the word in every case. Ejemplo, Rumania, ratón, rosa. When the letter R is after consonants N, L, and S. Ejemplo, Israel, sonrisa, alrededor. When the letter R is after the prefix S-U-B. Ejemplo, subrayar, subrayado. It's important to state that the double R digraph always sounds like an R in a hard way. By the way, do you remember what are the digraph? If not, then you could check it out on my video, which is on the link up there. Now, I would like to give you some examples so you can watch the contrast. Pero, perro. Pero, perro. Caro, carro. Caro, carro. Prosa, rosa. Prosa, rosa. Prosa, rosa. Presa, reza. Presa, reza. Presa, reza. Y bueno, eso es todo por hoy. If you have any question, opinion, or recommendation, just leave your comment below. And if you like this video, thumb up and subscribe. Soy Sebas y hasta la próxima.